Fluid power system, module number 5, pneumatic control circuits, lecture 5, cascade method. In the previous video, you have observed the signal conflict. The signal conflict is to achieve what you call the sequence as A plus, B plus, B minus, A minus. The memory wall, like a pilot operated memory wall, is getting signal at a time from both the side. So that is difficult to switch over to depending on the signal. So that signal conflict is going to be avoided by using the cascade method, or to eliminate the signal conflict, the cascade method was introduced. When is the sequence and the diagram, the operation will be the same. Only thing is, even the valves also the same, the circuit diagram will going to be changed. We will explain the circuit also. Before we know the step diagram, we will again, once again, I will explain the circuit. We have a clamping cylinder and the stamping cylinder. Cylinder A will be the clamping cylinder forward first, A plus, then hold for till the cylinder B forward and retract back. That means cylinder B is stamping, then retract back. After cylinder B retract, cylinder A will also retract to unclamp the component. With respect to the time is also the same. So first 5 seconds cylinder A forward, then the cylinder B forward, cylinder B retract. After 15 seconds, cylinder A need to retract back. So this is the condition. Total 20 seconds. If assume the cylinder required 5 seconds to move its forward and reverse condition. We'll see the circuit diagram. To do the circuit diagram, the components are going to be grouped in two groups. Say example, group 1. Group 1 is, see the dotted line. So it will get a supply from the group 1. Which are the valves are we will get a supply, we see in the next circuit. But here what you have, one memory wall is used to switch over the signal from group 1 to group 2. That is the one additional memory wall which is used. Normally we have 4 limit switches. That limit switches for two limit switches for each cylinder, total 4, and 2 normal pilot operated normal pilot operated 5x2 valve. That 5x2 valve with a pilot signal, that has a 2 valves, one individually for each cylinder. Additional to that, when you have one more pilot operated valve which used to switch over the signal from one group to other group, we will see the how the sequence of working in the next slide. Here will have the sequence of working. So first I will explain the circuit, how they are connected each other. First we can see group 1. See, this one will be the group 1 line. For the group 1 line, we connected B0 limit switch and A0 limit switch. Very important. For group 1, B0 limit switch, see B0 limit switch and A0 limit switch is connected with the group of 1. When that is the input signal from the group 1. Using this one, it will generate the output signals. We will see afterwards. Then the group 2 is connected to the limit switches of A1, limit switch A1 and limit switch B0. Limit switch B0. Initial condition is, we have the both the cylinder on the retract condition, B0 is also on and A0 is also on. So when is the A0 and B0 is on, then previous circuits you have observed the signal conflict. Here we see the whether the signal is conflict. See, if the B0 is on, if B0 is generate a signal, what will happen? It will generate a signal to this line. Please observe what is highlighting. It will generate a signal to this line. So I will change the color of L line. See, this will generate a signal to, oh, it's not visible. Generate a signal. See, when this one is generate a signal, that will be input signal to cylinder A or nothing but memory valve A. What about the A0 signal? See the A0. A0 is connected to the group B itself. Even that is also generating a signal, but that generated signal will switch the group itself. It will switch over the group itself. When the switch is group, so it will give a supply to group 2, which one? A0. When the A0 is high, the group 2 is high. If the group 2 is high, so the input signal, see, that will generate an input signal, right? A1, all right, and B1. It need to generate a signal as A1 and B1. When you press the start button, when you press the start button, not happen, we have a supply to group 2. See, initial supply, we have a group 2 circuit. When the start button is pressed, we attach a supply. It will give a supply to memory valve A. Memory valve 1.1 is actuated. It will get a supply from memory valve cylinder A forward. When the cylinder A forward, it a signal as A1. A1 is the signal is, see, where is the A1 signal? See, A1 signal, see, this limit switch will hit the signal. So that will generate a signal to this line. See, this line is connected to here. See, this line will give an input to second memory valve of cylinder B. Cylinder B will start move forward direction. When the cylinder move forward, B1 will hit. B1 will be have an input supply here. See, B1 also has an input supply from the same group. The B1 will have a supply from the same group. So B1 will generate a signal. So what will happen? See, B1 is connected, interconnected with the group changing valve. So it will give a supply to group change. So what will happen? The supply change, supply line itself going to be change the group. So what will happen when you change the group 1 will get the supply now. When the group 1 will get a supply, what will happen? According to the when the group 1 will get a supply, see, that will come to the supply, come to B0. B0 is off condition and will go to the A0. A0 is also the off condition. Now then how the sequence will start? Then B1, where is the B1? B1 will going to be hit the circuit. See, B1 is hit the circuit, will give a supply to this one. That group is interconnected. See, the group itself is connected to memory wall 2. When a supply B1 hit the supply, it will change the supply. Supply line when is changed, that itself will going to be change the input to the memory wall of 2, cylinder B. When the memory wall B is activated, so that will give an input signal to cylinder B to retract back. When the cylinder B retract, it will hit the B0 signal. The B0 signal will be given to this one. So B0 will generate a signal to input signal to memory valve 1.1. Memory valve 1.1 will next sequence is supply air cylinder air to rod end. Cylinder A retract. When cylinder A retract, A0 will hit. when the A naught is hit, see input supplied as A naught, when the A naught is hit, it will change the group supply itself. It will change the group supply itself. When it change, it will change the group supply to from one group to group two. When the group two is connected to cylinder memory wall or some limit switch of A1 and B1, and the same way it has a start button is connection. So until you get the start button, the next sequence will not start. This is how the cascade method will work. Thank you. For further details, you can contact me, Sandeep S., Department of Mechanical Engineering, Canada Engineering College, Pantola, and my mail ID is sandeepmysore07@gmail.com, and my contact number is 9900929394. Any clarification or any information, you can contact me with respect to this video. Thank you once again.